Hola, bienvenidos a mi canal una vez más y no te olvides de seguir comentando debajo qué tipo de videos quieres ver y si quieres que siga haciendo recetas, lo seguiré haciendo. Gracias.
Bueno, pues aquí ya me adelanté poquito. Aquí lo que quieren hacer es cortar todo el camarón en pedazos. Y esto es lo primero que quieren hacer antes de que empiecen a picar, o si van a picar, antes de que empiecen a descongelar el camarón, o antes de que lo pongan a curtir, deben de preparar primero el camarón y dejarlo curtiendo ya, y luego empezar a picar, para que así se curta más tiempo. O dejar el camarón de un día a otro también curtiendo en el limón. También eso ayuda. O sea, el chiste es que... Y así son los pedazos que tienen que quedar. Ni muy grandes ni muy chiquitos. Tampoco no muy chiquitos porque... Casi que van a querer hacer esto. Uno, dos, tres. Y si están muy chiquitos, nomás uno. Porque quieren poder servirse en la tostada también. Y que no se les caigan porque si están muy grandes, se les empiezan a caer. Y si están muy chiquitos, pues es mucho camarón el que vas a sentir más la verdura, pues, que el camarón. So, es mejor que haga pedacitos más grandes de camarón, porque ya ven que el limón lo curte y lo hace más chiquito, lo encoge. Pues así sucesivamente, esto es lo que quieren hacer. Quieren regar todo así una camita de camarón. Recarla. Y yo estoy usando más o menos como unas 2 libras o 3 libras de camarón, más o menos. Usé de las cajitas chiquitas como 4, creo. Y también camarón entero, yo lo hago así para disfrutarlo más en las tostadas, como lo comen tostadas tipo ceviche, pues creo que así es lo típico, ¿no? Picadito todo. Entonces, ya lavamos la tabla, ahora vamos a seguir con los limones. Ya están los limones lavados y son de 25 a 30 limones. So, vamos a ver cuánto juguito hacemos. Un tip que sí les doy es que hagan esto a todos los limones. Y esto es para que aflojen más juguito al momento de exprimir y así no le batallan también cuando expriman. Esto yo lo uso para exprimir o tal vez use este de aquí que está más chiquito. Pero a ver cuál. So, van a hacer eso a todos los limones. A todos los limones. Ya si tienen a su marido que haga esto, pues es mucho mejor que les ayude. Y quedan bien blanditos, no sé si se alcanza a ver aquí, pero los puedo apachurrar. Este ya está blandito. Igual y pueden hacer esto también, pero pues así lo haces en todo el limón, hasta en medio también. Y en todos los demás así sucesivamente. Se llegó el tiempo de cortar limones. Thank you. ¿Cuántos limones llevo? No los he contado a limpiar y me he puesto a... unos extras por si hace falta juguito, pero pues vamos a hacer todo, ¿verdad? Qué jugosito. Miren, miren nada más para que vean cómo, sin presionarle mucho, está súper jugosito, miren nada más. Yummy. Aquí está. Okay, look at the difference. This one is the one that I just put this one. And this one is the one that I just put this one. Okay, so honestly, I forgot to record how I poured the lemon there, but it will be there, focus in there, so you can see how it turns to pink. I'm gonna add, this is the black pepper, and this is the one I'm using. So I'm just gonna add it. I'm going to add on that. Something like that. And then you want to add. You want to add some oregano in here too. And this is half a tablespoon. And this is so much, how much you want to add. Not a lot, just a little bit. And you want to make sure that you mix everything. And then you want to add salt. Just, you want to add a little bit more. When I don't know. And then what you want to do, you want to move. Make sure you blend everything well. So once it's already mixed, you want to add a little bit more of lemon. And this is it. This is like around the, how much lemon you want to add for now. And later on, once you add the tomato, the onion, the cilantro, and the rest of the stuff, there's when you want to add more lemon if there's more lemon missing. But for now, this is like about the amount that you want to add. But yeah, I'm gonna let you see that, how that's gonna turn to pink. And I'm gonna continue to do more of that. One more line. Right? Are you guys ready to see some food porn?
orgy. There's some shrimp right there.
I knew I was missing something. Wow. My tomato.
No.
I was missing my tomato.
No.
So here's an example of what we have to do. First, I washed this really good with a sponge, but I didn't want to win. But yeah, this is what you want to do. You could do it with anything, but anything that does these little lines will work. You're gonna have to make a lot, maybe 3 carrots if they're too big, 2. And depending on how do you make the lines. After this thing, you're gonna cut them like in half. Or you're gonna try to fix them, and then cut them in half. And this makes the ceviche to taste more better, like even crunchier, and it just gives it another different flavor. I don't know if they make ceviches with this, but I always add carrots. I think they do, but I don't remember trying any of the carrots made like that. I don't know if they make them in little squares or I don't know. Don't forget to follow my social media, Reina Unique, on Facebook, my Facebook page. Or you can also find me in Instagram, Snapchat, any social media pretty much. Just search for Reina Unique TV. I'll post the name below. And if you want to see more of these type of videos doing recipes, just let me know in the comments below what type of food do you want me to make, and I'll be sure to make it. I mean, I love trying to make new foods. If I don't know how to make them, I'll try to make it first. If you want me to make it, I'll try to make it first, try it, and I always make food and give out to people before I even sell it or post a picture or try to sell or something, you know, so people could try it and see if it's a good flavor or not. So, I mean, this ceviche, it's already amazing. I know everyone loves it whenever I make it, so. It might become your favorite too, so you better give it a try. But yeah, this is what you want to do. This is not that clean, so I'm just gonna take this away. But yeah, I think I'm just gonna do this one and that's it. But let me finish to do this, then I'll be right back, okay?
Okay, so now time to continue with, oh, I'm sorry. Time to continue with
the tomato. And what you want to do is that you want to cut. You want to do this. Try to make them as thin as you can, please. And this is just so you won't be eating chunks of tomato or chunks of onion. Just try to do your vegetables thinner. Food will taste better and it will make you even add more vegetables, because sometimes you're like, oh, it looks like if you don't have a lot. And if it doesn't have a lot, you want more, right? This is the way they look. They're not that thin, but they're not that big either. So just try to make them really thin. Okay. And you're gonna continue to do that with all the tomatoes. And you wanna do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 tomatoes for like around this amount of shrimp. Now it's time to do. Did you see this?
No.
No, I'm not talking to you. Also, that onion must be really, really, really thin too, as well. That way you don't eat chunks of nasty onion. I don't know, I just don't like onion, so. If you like onion, you're more than welcome to do big chunks of onion. If you love onion, you can do big chunks of onion. I completely forgot. but I love Rachel. Together with the tomato.
Yes, and then
you wanna add onion. Since I add 5 tomatoes, I add 1 onion. I mean, since I added 10 tomatoes, I add 1 whole onion. And then the onion is really small, so. And the reason why I did the items like that, how you see me to do it in order, is because I only use one board, one cutting board right now, and the other, and they get really, it tends to get really stained with the cilantro. I'm leaving the cilantro at the end because the cilantro will get really bad if I cut it at the beginning. So the cilantro should always be the last thing you do because it gets really nasty and ugly. But the cilantro and the carrots stain the boards a lot. If you notice that after I finished doing the carrots, the board ended up being a little bit more orange. So I didn't want to stay a lot of time. I mean, a lot of the time doing the disinfecting and the board, so that's why I just decided to do it in order to be more cleaner. With the cilantro, you want to do the same thing. You want to cut first this part to clean. I already cleaned it, take off all the yellow parts. And now to cut it, what you want to do is you want to twist the most you can. Don't twist a lot, okay? Because then you're just going to smash this one. But after you finish twisting, twisting, you're just gonna go like that to it. And this is so you won't end up having a lot of those loose, big
pieces.
So this is how you want your cilantro to really small, and then you're gonna put it together with your stuff. What you wanna do, and then you wanna mix. Now what you wanna do is add the peppers. What you want to do, you want to take this out. And this is to prepare the spicy. It's just lemon. And this is just, in case you want it spicy, you could just add a little bit of this and it'll be ready to go. Okay, so you're gonna leave this for at least 3 hours before you serve. Okay, well the time has arrived and it's time to mix everything. So you wanna add everything in there. Half first. And then you wanna add a little bit of your shrimp, maybe your lemon. And then you wanna mix that first. So everything could get really mixed and both men. And then you wanna add carrots. You want a cucumber. You see how this is coming out? So delicious. Then you want to add the rest. Maybe that's it, but this is too much. I'll just leave that for another time. And for another thing. You want the rest. So this is how your signature should be looking now. I'm gonna add more carrots.
Okay, so after you're done mixing, this is the final product, and oh my Lord Jesus, it was delicious. It tasted amazing, honestly. I honestly challenge you to try it out. Do it like this, add the salsa loca, it's amazing. Look how it looks, it's just delicious. I decided to add the little seeds because they give more spiciness. But I honestly think it was a bad idea because I wanted to add just a lot of spoons of this salsita. It's super spicy, yummy. Give it a try and let me know what you think about this video, okay? Thank you. Bye-bye.